Hey there, measurement ladies and gentlemen. So good old universal analytics views are not available in GA4. How can we live with that? Well, let's have a look at it together. In this video, we will learn how to replicate views in GA4. And a spoiler alert, it is not possible to create an exact equivalent, and all workarounds have their limitations. Anyways, before we start with that, I would love to say a few words about the structure of GA4. And this is definitely one of the most frequently asked questions we are getting these days. So how should I structure my GA4 account? How should I create properties and streams? That's a very good question, especially considering the challenge that we are facing nowadays with the absence of views. All right, so let's have a look at the GA4 structure. So we have an account. Within an account, you can create properties, and within the property, you can create streams. And these are the three main pillars of GA4. One extremely important note here, a stream does not equal to a view in universal analytics. Okay, so let's go to my property, and here on the left side, we have this column with everything related to the account, whereas on the right side, we have property. And within a property, you can create data streams. And then we have this huge blank space that does not look super pretty. And this is exactly where views used to live in universal analytics. And I assume the creators of the tool simply preserved the structure, but we do not have views in GA4. Well, in the paid version, in GA4 360, you have kind of an equivalent of views that is called subproperties. But in order to access this feature, you have to pay for it, right? So you have to get the paid version of GA4, but in this video, we're focusing on the free version, and this is why we will not cover subproperties here. But you should know that such a feature exists. And just so that we are on the same page, what are views? These are the subsets of data. And the classical example in universal analytics could be the master view, which would be a working view, and you would apply multiple filters to configure it. Then the test view, that would serve as your testing environment, and then the raw data view with the plain data. This is one example. Another example could be separate views for different language versions of your website. For example, German version, English version, Dutch version, and so on. And this is what we used to have in universal analytics, but now it's not available. So what can we do here? We have two options, actually. Either to accept this challenge and to adjust to the reality by using the set of features that is available right now, or to get a paid version. So these are the options. Maybe this will be improved in the future, but on the day of the recording, we do not have views in GA4 and we do not have any specific solutions here. But we do have some kind of workarounds, and this is exactly what we will focus on in this video. So let me state my problem. So here I have MeasureSchool.com, and this is the main website that we have. And we also have live.measure.school, and this is where we conduct live trainings for a very limited group of people. But this is a part of a single user journey. This is why we track everything under one property, under one stream. Well, but how can I view the data separately? In good old universal analytics, I would create a separate view for this data set. But what can I do now? And I do not want to pay for GA4. Well, let's have a look together. So the first workaround is to use comparisons. So here you can see my pages and screens report. And let's say I want to look at that specific subset of data. So how can I do that? If you click edit comparisons or add comparison here, this is where you can add a new comparison. And we can look for something like host name. And then I can select live.measure.school, click OK, and then hit apply. And in this way, we can look at that specific subset of data. But we have some limitations here, because we cannot save this comparison. They do not persist in our reports. So if I close this one and then go back, it will not be available, which is not super convenient. And also, the conditions you can provide here are kind of limited, right? So these are the disadvantages of comparisons. So what could I do in this case? The second way of segmenting your data is to use filters, and you can do it in the standard reports in GA4. So let's say I want to have the same report, but for live.measure.school. So what can I do? If we click customize report, so this is where you can add a filter, and we also can say host name. And you see, this looks similar to comparisons. And this is where I can select live.measure.school and let's click apply. And now we can view the data only for live.measure.school, which is amazing. But what can I do? I can also save this report. So let's click save, and we want to save changes to a new report, and you should provide a name. So you should provide a nice descriptive name. I will do like this. You can also add a description to your report, and let's click save. Let's go back to our standard reports. And if I double check here, my report is not available. So what could be the reason? Well, because we have to go to library and we can see it right here, but we have to do one more thing. We have to add it to our collection. And you can see that it belongs to lifecycle. This is why we can click edit collection. And here I can look for my pages and screens, and let's drag and drop it. So here we go, and voila. And now we would have to click save to current collection, because we do not want to create a new one. And let's go back just to double check if it is available. And voila, so now we can see pages and screens, and this is my report. So this is the second way to filter out your data. But let's say you want to dive deeper into your data and you want to answer some specific questions with the data. This is why we should go to explore, and this is a third way to work with your data. So here I already created a report. So it's a freeform exploration, super simple, event name, event count. But let's say, again, we want to look at the data only for live.measure.school. And I can create this segment. So let's select event segment. And here, again, host name. And you can provide your conditions here. We have contains and live.measure.school. We can click apply. Again, you should provide a proper name. You can also add a description, and let's click save and apply. And this segment will be automatically applied to your report. And now we can look at this specific subset of data for our analysis. But there are also some limitations here, because each time you create a new exploration, you would have to create this segment from scratch. So you cannot share those segments between your explorations, unfortunately. What could we do in this case? So this is how we can deal with views within the tool. But if this does not satisfy your needs, we can go even a step further. In this case, we would have to use some external tool. And this could be Looker Studio or BigQuery. Here you can see a simple report that I created. And I'm not showing off my designer skills here for sure, but it's just created for testing purposes. And here we can see the data all together. But let's say I want to filter it out somehow. So what could I do? So one of the options is to create a filter. So I can go to file, and here we have report settings. And this is where I can add a filter, and I can say create a filter, and we will call it again LMS, just as an example. You should provide a proper name, of course. Here we have include, And then we will look for host name. Awesome. And then equals to, we have live.measure.school. And let's click save. And in this way, we can work with that specific subset of data. So this is one option, or let me delete this one. We could do it in a different way. So let's say a person who is working with the report wants to have more control over the data and wants to look at the whole data set as well as at that specific data set for live.measure.school. So in this case, we can add a control and say drop down list. Let's put it here. Now we have country, so we should replace that. Let's say host name. Great. And here we go. So now we can say, okay, this is what I want to analyze. So let's uncheck those. And we got the same numbers, which is great. But let's say you are still not happy with it, especially now that Google has turned out quota limiting for the Looker Studio, you might not be satisfied with this workaround. So what could we do? In this case, the GA4 BigQuery export comes to our rescue. So let's have a look at it together. So I'm in BigQuery right now, and this is a data warehouse that offers you so much flexibility as well as control over your data. And the super cool thing about GA4 is that we have a free connector available, and before it was only possible for the paid version. So this is a considerable improvement of the tool. And the speed here is simply brilliant. So you can query through huge sets of data within just seconds. And this is another workaround, how to deal with views, but it will definitely require more advanced skills. And you should also know SQL. But the good thing here is that we offer a free tutorial on YouTube, which was created by the one and only Julian. And also within the membership in Measure Masters, we have a super cool, beginner-friendly, extensive 5-hour course created by our magician Prabha. And I would definitely recommend taking one of those because the tracking landscape is changing and BigQuery offers a lot of advantages. Anyways, so here you can see that I'm working with the data. And I can define the data set I want to work with, so you can model your data. Then you can export it to a separate view, and then you can also visualize it in the Looker Studio. So here I started working on my report, and you would not face any quota limitations, which is also a positive thing. So just to sum up, a stream in GA4 does not equal to a view, and it is a very common misconception. It is not recommended to create multiple web streams under one property. So if you do not want to analyze your data together, then it is better to create separate properties for that. You can also utilize comparisons, filters, and segments to work with your subset of data within GA4 itself, or other solutions would involve some external tools, such as Looker Studio or BigQuery. So we have explored different ways how to deal with views in GA4. And I have to say that these workarounds are not perfect. What workaround do you use? Please let us know in the comment section below. And if you like this video, give us a thumbs up and please not forget to subscribe. See you next time. Happy measuring!